गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास सिक्स एंड वेलकम बैक टू योर रिकॉर्डिंग क्लास. लास्ट टाइम वी हैड कंप्लीटेड चैप्टर वन कैटेगरीज ऑफ कंप्यूटर्स एंड कंप्यूटर लैंग्वेजेस. आई एम श्योर यू मस्ट हैव गॉन थ्रू द पीडीएफ दैट आई हैड सेंड यू. टुडे आई विल जस्ट डू द एक्सरसाइजेस. ओके, वी विल डिस्कस दिस एक्सरसाइज सेक्शन. मल्टीपल चॉइस, फिल इन द ब्लैंक्स, ट्रू एंड फॉल्स एंड मैच द फॉलोइंग आई विल डिस्कस विद यू टुडे. So listen carefully, and if you have your books, you can just underline. And after that, you have to do this in your computer exercise copy. Okay, you have to make one computer exercise copy neatly. You have to write chapter one, and you start doing your exercises in your copy. Okay. So exercise section number one is a multiple choice questions. If you have your book or if you have your PDF, you can refer to that later on. It converts a high level languages program line by line to a machine language. So your answer would be assembler, compiler, interpreter and processor. So children, for multiple choice question A, number one, your answer will be C. Compiler. Okay, you just write down this answer, compiler. Number two, a program written in assembly language is called, we have discussed the program that is written in assembly language, it is called assembly language. Means I told you about it, the languages which is the code which is known as a mnemonic code. So it's called source code. Number three, this language uses strings of only zeros and ones to give instruction to the computer. So children, first time I've discussed about the machine programming language. I told you about the machine language. So machine language uses two digits, that is zero and one. Okay, so your answer will be machine language. For number four, which of the following statement is not true about supercomputers? Okay, let me read the statement. They can process trillions of instructions per second. They are used for complex data requiring high speeds of operation for the processing of data. And they are used in research centers, and they are used for large amount of transactions. So which one is not true? First one is true, because supercomputers can process trillions of instruction per second. I told you about it, and these are used for complex data processing. This is also true, and they are used in research centers. This is also true. The last statement is not true. So now your answer will be number D. They are used for large amount of transaction. This statement is not true. Okay, now number five, a mini computer is gaming console. This is not true. Desktop, this is not true. HP 2100 and PDP 10. Your answer will be HP 2100. For number 5, your answer will be, I think it's B or C. C. HP 2100 will be your answer. That is, this is an example of mini computer. Okay? So you have to write this in your copy. Now comes fill in the blanks. So children, you have your video, you can pause and you can write your answer in your computer copies. Okay, so let me do fill in the blanks. First one, a dash is a type of computer that has no keyboard and can also be used for making calls. So children, which computer? Okay, it's a computer only. Which device has no keyboard? So you can guess, as I've already discussed, it is a smartphone. Okay, your answer will be smart . So you know the smartphone doesn't have a virtual keyboard. It doesn't have a keyboard. It has a virtual keyboard. Okay, you have to type directly on the screen. But it is also a type of computer, and the smartphone will help you to make calls. You know that. Number two, a dash are smaller computers that run on microprocessor in their central processing unit. Which type of computer is that? Which has a microprocessor? It's a microcomputer. Number C, a dash translates the entire program written in a high-level language into machine-level language in Go. So last time I have told you about a language processor. Three types of language processors are there: compiler, assembler, and translator. So for this, your answer will be compiler. Okay. Note down. Number four, a dash is a formal language designed to communicate instructions to a computer. Which language is a formal language, children? Language will be a programming language. Okay, for number D, the answer will be programming. Programming language. Okay, the answer will be programming language. And number five, assembly language uses very short words for commands known as dash to give instruction to the computer. This one also we have already discussed. Your answer will be assembly language uses what? It uses source code. Okay, your answer will be source code, right? So children, please note down this one also, fill in the blanks also in your computer exercise copy. Now I will do true and false out here. True and false, this is number C, this one is B. True and false is C. C-Ray, C-R-A-Y, C-Ray 1 is an example of supercomputer. Is it true or false? You can have a look at your PDF also. C-Ray 1 is an example of supercomputer. The answer is true. Okay. Number two, a program written in high-level language is known as an object code. No, a program written in high-level language is not called an object code. This is false. Three, mainframe computers are used by large organizations, airlines, and banks. This is true, because I've already told you about mainframe computers. These are used by the airlines, and these are used for the large amount of transaction in bank also. These are used. This is true. Number four, microcomputers are inserted inside devices or electronic appliances to perform and control some specific task. No, not microcomputers are not used to perform specific task. This is false. Number four will be false. And last but not the least, number five, a computer can understand English language. Do you think that computer can understand English language? Computer understands only machine language. So your answer will be false. It understands only codes, binary codes, okay? Machine language. Now comes number D, match the following. Okay? So So children, when you are copying this, when you are doing these exercises in your computer copy, make sure you write the questions, you write all the options, and only then only you will write the answers that is given by me, okay? Here I'm just writing the answers, but you have to write the question also, and you have to write the answers also at the same time, okay? Just do not copy the answers only. You have to write the questions also, okay? Now come, match the following. The following one is super supercomputer. Number two is given mini computer. Number three it's given mobile computer. Number four, it's given mainframe computer. And number five, it's given microprocessor. So here, I will be writing the answers only, okay? That's the following. You have to copy the question also, and you have to copy the answers also at the same time, okay? So match the following. There are so many options given. One is given desktop, one is given NEC 610, one is given CDA 160A, one is given CRAY 1, and one is given PMPMP, okay? So for the supercomputer, your answer will be, since we have already done this in multiple choice also, CRAY 1. This is the answer for your supercomputer, okay? Now number two, mini computer. Mini computer is CDA 160A. This is the answer for mini computer. Mobile computer. Mobile computer is PMP. Mainframe computer. Mainframe computer is NEC 610. So these are the names of the computer. These are the examples of computers, okay? And the last one, microprocessor, is Radeon desktop, which we have. This is microprocessor desktop. So these are just the match the following, okay? We are just matching the answers. These are the examples of those computers, okay? So these things you have to note down in your computer exercise copy. Since from chapter 1 only you start doing your exercises in your computer copy, okay children? So next class I will be sending you answer in one word and answer the following, because answer the following questions, the answer will be long, so I won't be able to write it down here. So I will be sending you the PDF. You have to note down, okay? So today evening, by today evening only, I'll send you the PDF for E and F, okay? So you have to note down in your computer copy. And next class I will be starting chapter 2, that is file management and organizations of data. So before that, I will send you the PDF of this chapter also. Make sure you read the PDF, okay? But before that, you have to complete question answer from chapter 1, okay? Thank you, class.